Ladies and gentlemen, with that, we will be moving now to our next panel discussion, which will discuss regional media, a defining factor in future of communications, and how it will become a game changer. So ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming our session chair, Mr. Anoop Sharma, Senior Director, PRCAI, to join us on screen and introduce us to our panelists, as well as take the discussion forward. Very warm welcome to you, Mr. Sharma.
Hi, Kathy. From one Sharma to another, it's always a pleasure. And it's so good. I think one of the key thing what Atul, the senior panelist before me, said that we need to get used to the new word, which is phygital. So yesterday, I think who better than us can say, yesterday we saw you on the stage and Atul on the backstage. I mean, of course, behind the stage there. And today I am so fortunate that I am sharing this space on a digital. And as Dr. Batra had mentioned that this is going to be the future. I mean, I think almost all the events are going to be in this format of half digital, half physical. So thank you very much, Kathy. And I think I would just like to take one is that first, it's a very good that we are working on a era where digital is playing a key role, and very important that one of the sessions which we are taking is on regional communication, particularly when we see the power of region going high. And very interesting panel, I think we have got already. So if I can introduce and get some of our panelists back on the stage. Sheila K. Panikkar, she's the founder of Enright PR. Welcome, Sheila.
Hello.
Then we have Shailesh Goyal, a founder and director of Simulation. Welcome, Shailesh Bhai. And from my home state, Bihar, I have Khurshid Ahmed, the founder and managing director of Advantage Group. Welcome, Khurshid Bhai.
We are here for
Mukesh Kharwanda, one of our key young, I would say, the talent in the PR industry, playing a very important role in the regional PR, but going all pan across. Welcome, Mukesh. So nice to have you all here.
Thank you, Anoop. Good evening.
Thank you.
One of the things which I would say is that when Karan was giving this topic, I said that, I mean, we had a bit of a discussion that what do we say? Is regional media the future of communication? So I remember a discussion which we had with Mukesh, I think it was 2 years back, when we said that regional is always a game changer. You don't have to actually put it. So then we thought, okay, let's put it that it's defining factor in the future of communication without going much into the game changer. And I think one of the key factors which has come is that in the lockdown period, we have seen that how the power of regional media particularly came into the picture. We saw how the rural markets expanded and how some of the stuff which we saw was that how the market is changing from the perspective that now it is the regions which are going to be playing the key important role in terms of driving the consumption. I'll just take a step back in understanding that during the last 1 year, we have seen, I mean, for this particularly if we see the COVID era, the consumption increased more or less very high, primarily because one of the things that people were at home and they were consuming more or during the lockdown. And in that, the consumption started very high in terms of the regional communication or what we call the local communication, which was happening. Also, what happened was during this time, we also saw a lot of changes in the media. And this was changing very fast. And people started wanting more and more of news, but more what is happening at their local level. All this actually started making us as PR professionals, as communicators, and earlier we heard that there is a time that it's no more just we need to tweet about it. We also need to cool about it. So, Mr. Sharma. And in that, we say whether it was then the Prime Minister called of Atmanirbhar and how we need to be more and more there. So for that, the whole stuff became that, are we more Atmanirbhar? Are we going regional?
Mr. Sharma, can I, sorry to interrupt you. I need to, I'm not sure if you can hear me.
So
can everybody else hear me?
Yes.
I'm trying to tell him to speak louder because the volume is really low.
How is
the audience can hear him as well?
How do you see it growing relevance during these current times?
Anup Khayati is telling you to be a little louder.
Am I audible better?
Yeah, you'll have to be a little louder, Mr.
Yes,
Sharma.
Yes.
Volume is quite low.
The world of fiddler.
Yes. So thank you, Anup. Thank you so much. So we have seen in the recent times also, and over the period of last decade, we have seen that in the many a top English media houses or the international media houses, international publications, all they were growing and expanding very fast, have now disappeared from many a city editions, many a branches, and many a places. And also, of course, the pandemic has expedited this process. And in our own city, if you talk, we saw. We were having the practically bureau and the news crew, the camera crews of almost everybody, be it the Star News, Aztag, and everybody has worked. Now, in last couple of years, if you see, the regional media has taken over, and all the national media, national publications, their bureaus have started disappearing, closing one by one, actually. So what is this indication is? This indication is about that the average person is not worried, not concerned much about what Barack Obama is saying or what Trump is doing, but he is concerned about what is happening in the next street next to him. You know, as we popularly and jokingly say, ki agar gaon mein charwahe ka char bakri bhi gum jata hai aur wo news akhbar mein aata hai, so he feels elated and he feels related. Okay, so that gives him feel. And this is the same thing which has been realized by the marketeers, the brand communicators, and everybody who has seen the seriousness of the reader and the viewer more deeply getting engaged in the regional media, which is giving them more value for time, more value of money and ROI, because the engagement levels are much better there. We have seen the OTT's growth. Every OTT platform, any platform, they have multiple languages. Now you see the same serial, same episode is available into the languages, more than a dozen languages of South and North. And I mean, even Hindi, which is most popularly accepted, also has its variant. And you see the Bhojpuri, we see the Punjabi versions, we see the even the Mithila versions also, because they want to go deeper and deeper and connect with the audience which is residing in the village level and below that level. So this growth is bound to happen, and the proliferation of media which started giving the choices to the reader or the viewer is now is very clear, and is now filtered. So that's how we see that the growth is coming from the. So all the ETVs, the in TV9s, and the, I mean all the Gujarati channels, like we say, or all the Bhojpuri channels have. They have not only stayed, survived, but grown, while the other national channels have started closing their bureaus and depending largely on the news agencies and such sites. So this is clear indications that the preference has shifted to regional media, and it will continue. And this is what I feel, that regional media over a period of coming 5 years will become very dominant, very predominant. And each marketeer, brand or manufacturer of product or service will have to focus and strategize separately. Because as we say in India, each state is like a country by itself. There is one Europe in Gujarat, and there is one Australia in probably two states of us. So you cannot have the single strategy which is working across the country. Over to you, Anup.
Well said, Sarish bhai. In fact, you bring so much of power to the region. It reminds of one of our senior colleagues who spoke earlier, Mr. Madan Behal. Leads one of the largest PR firm in this part of the world, and I would say one of the biggest, which is expanding the market. So one of the things which he said, which is very pertinent to what reflects to what you said, is that he said that the Indian PR industry is growing rapidly, but
yeah,
it is still minuscule compared to what we are seeing in the larger market. In fact, he gave the numbers that it is even smaller than some of the billing of some of the larger PR firms and consultancies across the world. Now, if we take from that it means that we have not yet explored our market. And Chalit bhai, what you said is pretty big. So, Sheila, I mean, if I may come to you, taking from there what Chalit bhai said, and just taking the cue of what Madam Bell we are told from a perspective that the Indian market is still low. So do you see that the inclination of the brands, particularly what we see the brands here, are for more for regional media coverage? And is it shifting just during the pandemic side, or is the inclination going to be there as a trend now? Sheila, if I ask you.
Sheila, you are on mute.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, we can.
So I was saying that, you know, I take from Sailesh, you know, what he said is, you know, yes, it's absolutely, you know, regional media and regional PR is very dominant now, you know, for a simple reason that many of them want to know, you know, what is happening in their own region, one. And number two, you know, if I have to say, the media in particular, you know, taking from what he said, you know, in Hyderabad, we have a couple of dailies, which are the English as well as the Telugu, the local language, you know, which get to more, you know, the local stories as well, the national stories, what the, you know, people want to read. And coming to PR agency as such, you know, regional PR agency, we have, you know, Hyderabad is happening, Hyderabad, and many big companies, you know, whether, you know, it is from FinTech or HR Tech or pharmaceuticals, many people sit here. And most of them, when we, you know, approach or, you know, when we talk, the main brownie point we get is that, you know, being headquartered here. You know, they want someone who is headquartered here, and then they can, they who can, you know who knows the length and breadth of the region, and who can, you know, go along with the media, and you know, who can cater to their need and take them along, you know, across the globe too. You know, so someone they want to sit here and help them to take them around. You know, that is one point number one. And coming to the media point, you know, the regional media, you know, we have, as Sailesh said, you know, ETV Bharat is an example where they have different kind, different languages, right? They are, and BBC, the international one, you know, where they have BBC Telugu, BBC Tamil, BBC Malayalam. So those kind of thing, you know, time and again proves that, you know, there are regional takers, you know, and more people want to know what is happening around them, and you know, also beyond, you know, and you know, having said that, you know, people say, for example, Telugu, you know, the local language here, you know, we have readers across the globe, so and you know, we are all going digital too, so we have, it's not just a print edition, right, elsewhere, who sits and, you know, reads the paper that is through e-paper, you know, maybe in US or in UK, so it is spread across, so regional has no boundary as of now, but you know, it is a geography where you can really take things beyond that particular geography is what we I feel.
Well said. I mean, region has no boundary.
Anup, I can't hear you.
Line divide two nations or two people.
Anup, I can't hear you.
I'm sure if you would have attended the earlier session where we have, like you mentioned, with MNC, so we had, I think, Mr. Jayaraman, Kishore Jayaraman from Rolls-Royce, where he spoke about two particular things like accessibility and be informed in a larger context. I mean, he said that in pandemic has taught us that you need to be accessible. And second is you need to be informed. So like you mentioned that the regional, some of the regional publications are important. And if you see that currently the FMCG and durable brands with a mass market, I mean, they say that in their case, the market is mass. That's why they're. And if we say, let's take, if we say Mukesh, like in your home state of Punjab, where you primarily operate from, I mean, a Punjab-based company, the makers of Cremica, their parent company, Mrs. Bechter, they had an IPO, which was oversubscribed during the pandemic times, 198 times. And if I get the numbers right, it was around 40,000 crores. So one size fits all or one size doesn't fit all. So Mukesh, tell me, like, I mean, you operate from primarily one of the regions, but like Sheila said, your boundaries are beyond. So what does a regional PR firm play a role in terms of the campaign planning? for a national brand, and at a local level, how do you do it, and what are the typical tools which you use? Mukesh, for you.
Yeah, Anoop, thank you first of all for hosting this panel and organizing this. And it is always a pleasure to see a platform like Exchange for Media giving preference and time to regional communication, which is a topic which is very dear to my heart. And I've been working in it for 10 years. To coming to your question, Anoop, when we talk of regional PR or public relations on the large, I think we do public relations only for two primary reasons. One is image perception. Second is amplification. And if I see the boundary of India, 75% of population resides in regional India. So I don't see the question arises about the importance and need of regional public relations in India. If you are willing to leave out 75% of your TG, then the role of regional communication or regional PR is nothing. But if you are willing to take on that 75% of population, then it is everything for your brand or for your service. On the tools that I talk about, I think the only roadblock that regional PR agencies had was the strategic interface. But it gives me pleasure to see Shailesh Bhai on the panel, who's been working in the field for far many more years than me. And we have Sheila from Hyderabad and Khurshid Bhai from Bihar. More and more people we have who are taking responsibility or giving shining moments to regional PR in specific regions or pan-India, I think that will give importance or that kind of confidence to brands that regional PR people can also give you the strategic interface that is required. It is not only about the amplification anymore. I think once that is done, I think regional PR will only have places to go from here. Yeah, on the tools, I think you rightly mentioned, Anoop, and I'll take from what Shailesh Bhai also said. It has just moved from dissemination of news to storytelling. So be it traditional mediums or digital mediums or the regional digital influences that we have, it is all about telling the story in the native language, in the way that a person sitting in these regional areas can connect with it. So that is the primary difference in tools or the usage of tools that I see, which has happened more so in 2020 and will continue to happen in times to come.
Thank you, Mukesh. I mean, that's wonderfully put that, and that you, I love the way you stitched in stuff. So one of the key things that you said is that earlier, I mean, this year we have seen it's all about like crisis. And I think nothing better than E4M to put the panel, one of the first panel which they had was on crisis management. And here I would try and bring Khurshid Bhai, if he's there. If you can tell that particularly in a state like Bihar, where region plays a very important role, what are the two or three key challenges which you feel in terms of managing a PR campaign? Khurshid Bhai, for you.
Thank you, Anoop Bhai. First of all, I'll talk about regional in Hindi. Because our Hindi is a lot bigger. Our Hindi circulation, which you will see, is about 1 crore. रीडरशिप 1 करोड़ है और 35 लाख की सर्कुलेशन है, तो मैं हिंदी में बात करूंगा। इंग्लिश वहाँ बहुत कम है, सिर्फ 3 पेपर है वहाँ इंग्लिश के और उसकी 70,000 की सर्कुलेशन है। तो हिंदी में बात करूँ मैं आपसे?
बिल्कुल सर, बिल्कुल।
तो रीजनल में आया तो अपनी लैंग्वेज में बात करते हैं। आपने कहा कि चैलेंजेस क्या है, चैलेंजेस तो हर जगह होती है, सिर्फ तो अलग अलग स्केल पे होती है। जितनी चैलेंजेस है वहाँ अपॉर्चुनिटी भी उतनी है, वहाँ काम करने में मज़ा आता है। 28 साल से हम लोग वहाँ हैं और पीआर की जो कैंपेन है आज वर्ल्ड में उसकी गूंज होती है। जैसे टोबैको फ्री बिहार हम लोगों ने कैंपेन चलाई, अपना पटना सुंदर चलाई, तो रीजनल मीडिया उसको उठाती है। सर ये बताया शैलेश भाई ने कि वो उसको मतलब नहीं है कि ट्रंप क्या कर रहे हैं, उसको मतलब ये है कि अब बिहार में क्या होने वाला। हर इंसान अपने हित की बात करता है, तो मुझे क्या मिलेगा। तो पेपर में वही चाहिए रीडर को, तो ये संपादक देखते हैं या उनकी टीम देखती है जो पढ़ना चाहते हैं। तो ऐसी कुछ बातें नहीं और उसको प्लान करनी पड़ती है और हम वहाँ के एक्सपर्ट्स हैं तो हम लोग कैंपेन चलाते हैं। लेकिन एक मेजर प्रॉब्लम जो आती है कि बहुत सारी घटना ऐसी होती है जो कि नेशनल बन सकती है। जैसे पॉजिटिव अभी हाल में ही देखें कि हेल्थ में जो हालात थे आज से 4 महीना पहले, अभी हम लोग नंबर 1 है। बिहार में वैक्सीन सबसे हाईएस्ट है, 76.6%, जबकि मध्य प्रदेश पीछे में है। लेकिन ये न्यूज़ अगर नेशनल में आनी चाहिए, अगर आप निगेटिव छापते हैं जरा से भी कुछ होता है क्राइम तो पूरे वो इंडिया में हर चैनल में दिखाया जाता है। तो ये एक प्रॉब्लम है मीडिया की कि जो चीज़ बॉम्बे में हो रही है दिल्ली में हो रही है तो उसको ज़्यादा दिखाते हैं। अब जैसे दिल्ली बॉम्बे में बारिश हो गई तो पूरे चैनल में वही दिखाया जा रहा है, जबकि बिहार में बहुत सारी अच्छी चीज़ें हो रही है, आप इसको आप यही दिखाते हैं। तो ये चैलेंजेस है और ये अच्छा भी नहीं है। तो हमको लगता है कि मीडिया को थोड़ा ध्यान देना चाहिए वैसी चीज़ पर जो चीज़ अच्छी हो रही है। अब हमारे यहाँ लालोही साहब थे, मैजिक थे मीडिया के लिए, किसी भी चैनल के देखिए वहाँ लगा रहता था। तो ऐसा जैसे कहते हैं कि नो न्यूज़ इज़ द गुड न्यूज़, अगर न्यूज़ नहीं है तो बहुत अच्छा है। तो ये मीडिया को देखना होगा सेंटर से कि हमारे जो दिल्ली में है बॉम्बे में है कि मीडिया में सारी चीज़ें अगर अच्छी हो रही है तो उसको भी उठाएं और नेगेटिव हो रही तो उसको एक्सक्लेट नहीं करें। अभी आपको याद होगा अनु भाई, जब हम लोग कोविड में थे तो चैनल पर सिर्फ एक ही चीज़ चल रही थी बिहार की, वो सुशांत सुशांत सुशांत, इंसान उस चैनल को बंद कर दे रहा था। और भी चीज़ें हो रही थी, आप हेल्थ की बातें करें, आप स्पोर्ट्स की बातें करें, वो नहीं होता है। इसको कैसे आप ले जाएंगे आगे, हमको मेरा मैसेज है कि बाकी सब पहलू को भी देखना चाहिए और जब सब जगह आप बुरा छाप रहे हैं किसी के बारे में तो अच्छा भी आपको दिखाना चाहिए। थैंक यू अनु भाई,
बहुत बढ़िया खुर्शीद भाई। इनफैक्ट आपकी बात वो है दैट अगर सिर्फ बुरा न्यूज ही नहीं अच्छा न्यूज भी चलना चाहिए। और इसी पे एक जो हमारे प्रधानमंत्री ने बात बोली थी, शैलेश भाई आपके केंचो से हम प्रधानमंत्री हमारे वहीं से आते हैं, तो मैं कहूँ कि उनका एक जो बात ये अभी कोविड के टाइम में बड़ा ये था कि आत्मनिर्भर होना है और वोकल फॉर लोकल। तो इसमें अभी एक पैनल डिस्कशन पहले हुआ था जिसमें डॉक्टर बत्रा बात कर रहे थे, एक इंडियन होम ब्रांड है, वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट होम ब्रांड कंज्यूमर ब्रांड विच हैज कम अप इज बोट, बिल्कुल नाम की तरह है बोट जो नाव इधर से उधर ले जा रहा है, आई थिंक बोट ब्रांड। सो अमन गुप्ता इज को फाउंडर, आई मीन व्हेन ही सेड दैट यू नो इट इज if you have to be pertinent to the consumers it is very important that you listen to the consumer and that's why jaise aapne bola ya kushik bhai bole ki local ki baat sunni bahut zaruri hai tabhi wo uske upar integrate hoga to usme agar gujarat se hi baat karte hain agar to sanil bhai agar aap se main ek minute mein agar puchna chahu ki jaise ek wagh bakri brand jo local thi aur ek have more brand jo thi aur pradhanmantri ab bol rahe hain going to vocal for local. So, how do you think regional media will play a role in bringing a regional brand national? I mean, very quickly, if you can just tell us. Tell us why.
Yes. So, the initial flip which is required for a regional brand to grow, the regional media helps them gaining the critical mass. And once the critical mass comes, I mean, one of the biggest example we have is our Amul, the very own brand Amul, which is not only grown nationally from a small town called Anand, and now it is international level and exporting to many other countries as well. Okay, so what do you think? This has come out of the regional media's presence and regional media's support and regional media's strength. So the highlight of the programs, highlight of the brand came from the success stories, the positive stories, the aspects which were unknown to the public, and how good and benefit it did for the beneficiaries, for the farmer producers, and for the ladies. So once that is highlighted, it is started amplifying, it has started getting amplified to the national level and international level, and the impact came on the brand also. So like the examples you said, Wagh Bakri or the Hemmoor or the Wadi Lal, so all these regional brands have grown beyond the state of Gujarat, and now they are national level players actually. Yeah, so impact has come from what has been contributed by the regional media, the support which they gave, the marketing, the branding support which has got it from the regional media in communicating the good and the benefits about it. Now, local for vocal, what, as you are saying, the Prime Minister has given, it has two aspects. One is, yes, take the things global. Okay, so we have just seen the examples, and there are many more examples which are going across the world. The product, one of the popular example is the Indu and Khakra Wala. Now, this has become a savory which is being relished by the people across the world, actually. And how it became a brand, so and in the cottage industry. So all that supported it actually. And the other aspect is the hyperlocalism. So hyperlocalism is the thing which is now it's not a buzzword. It is the word which is important for every marketing person. You see, we give examples of McDonald's, we give examples of the KFC, we give examples of all the multinational brands who have entered, who have not only entered in this area, but they were forced to adapt the preferences of the regional area. Now, again, another popular example is they all have had to convert into Jain pizzas. You know, now have you heard it ever in Paris or in New York? Never. But today, this has become a brand in the menu of the KFC or the McDonald's. Okay. So the regionalism has its own charm, its own strengths, and the connect it offers with the masses within the geography is beyond comprehension, and it's a market nobody can ignore actually.
Thank you,
sir. Over to you.
Quickly, so one of the things which in the digital world is also about the time, and yes, digital has played a very key role. So Sheila, I would like in a very crisp format, I mean these days it's all about snackable content, and earlier panel before us were discussing about how digital has played a key role and bringing the influencer marketing. So one of the things which we have seen is that even in digital, it is going local. And a lot of language is being there. And some say that there are three V's which have come. I mean, it's the four P's where there are marketing now in the current context of content. They say there are three V's, whether it be video, voice, and vernacular. So if I ask you that, how much do you think has digital played a key role in regional media campaigns? Sheila, if you may ask.
Yeah. So the fulcrum of business has changed, Anup. You know, it's totally different now. You know, you just imagine 2020 without internet and being digital, you know. We are not sure, you know, or we are not even thought about it. And coming to your point, you know, I'm not sure whether you've seen a recent ad of TVS Scooty Pep, you know, which got launched. It went viral. You know, it was a small clip of, on a digital platform. See, this exactly showed how, you know, a big brand like TVS is going regional. So it was nothing but, you know, they just, on top of the, you know, where they put the logo, they put First Love in Tamil, and then, TVS Scooty Pep, you know, down. So the logo just had the First Love on top and then the logo down in Tamil. And they beautifully made a video saying that how they changed it, how the whole culture of Tamil Nadu was shown in that. And how the youth, see, basically the pep is for youth, you know. So how those set of people, you know, we are not talking about, elderly people wanting to read a Tamil newspaper or a, you know, Telugu newspaper or a Malayalam newspaper or a regional newspaper for that matter. So the brand itself showed that, you know, the younger generation is also wanting to consume the news which is coming through their own language, you know, and it could reach or, you know, it would touch the chord well, is what the company also thought. So that's why they did ad like that. And it went viral and it was fantastic. Yeah.
Very interesting. So, one of the things which you said is how brands are transforming their messaging. And Mukesh, I'm sure that you heard before us, when our Kunal Sinha, from Value 360, and also the PRCA vice president, he was talking that how, when he was talking about the PR industry size, that he brought from what Madan Bailey told about the national perspective, and then how in India, how we are expanding. And he said the market is not even touched what it is there going to be, and it's going to be exploding. And one thing which Kunal said was that is the regional PR, which is going to become a major player. So, you are a young, talented guy yourself, and you work primarily from a region, but have pan-India work. Your clients are looking at very strategic input. So what kind of challenges did you feel, if I ask from a talent perspective? Because there is a myth that we don't have talent at the region level. So, Mukesh, my pertinent question to you is that, do you think that industry is relying on people talent, but at the region level, we are not getting enough talent. Mukesh, just make it short, and if you can answer this.
Yeah, I understand, Anoop. If for this question, if you allow me to be absolutely blunt and honest, I think that's a challenge when it comes to regional talent and will remain so. But I don't think there is any outside factor because of which this is happening. It is only because of the regional PR players not doing the kind of stuff we should be doing, and I include myself also in it. When I see the talent transition in the past 5 years, it has been great. Right now in regional PR space also, we have people who can give strategic inputs and also take care of the media part as well across the country. We have our own offices in 13 cities, and I can say almost all the places we have a client servicing executive and a media executive to find the match between a person who can handle media and who can understand how the PR part of it works and be a client servicing executive remains a challenge still, primarily because of three reasons, Anoop. One, I feel exposure. Regional PR firms, most of them, I say 90% of them, are not able to provide the kind of exposure one gets in a national PR firm. And that is primarily because we are working. Most of the regional PR firms are working with national PR firms and not working with direct clients. Second would be the pay scales. If we really want talent to be retained in regional cities, we really have to put our might, put our pocket behind what we are saying and raise our pay scales to a level of a national, good national agency. Third, which I think is the most important. Right now, if I talk of national PR, there are people like Prema Sagar, Deepshika, Nitin Mantri, Madan Behal, you mentioned Atul Sharma, Ashwini Singla, Nikhil Day, Valerie Pinto, so many of them which people look up to and want to work with and learn from. Those are your national PR role models. If I talk of a regional PR space, I can hardly think of 4 or 5 people, and beyond that, there is a lull. So more role models we have, and more we put our might behind what we are saying by increasing pay scales, by giving them exposure, and the kind of amenities and learning that they get at a national agency by investing into their learning, I think this is a challenge that we need to sail through. Nobody else can do it for us.
Wonderful.
Very well said. I mean, you,
Mr. Sharma, I'm sorry to interrupt again, but my role to be here is a timekeeper as well.
I'll get back to you.
So, thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody. I mean, I really enjoyed interacting with you all, and it's the kind of inputs we got. Thank you, Sheila, Mukesh, Shailesh Bhai, and Kushit Bhai. And of course, thank you, the E4M group there. So before we end, just let's pray that we all stay safe and let's keep the mask on.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you so much,
all our panelists.
Thank you, Kyati. Thank you, Anup. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Kava.